it, man. How many people do you know that you put down and you want an argument with feel good about it?
Nope.
Nope. They want revenge.
Mm-hmm.
They want revenge, and they may not even, you may have been able to save a soul, but since you were so harsh with them, you didn't. And that's not walking in the spirit, no matter how you look at it. A lot of us have run things very wrong, man. When you make a comparison to HaMashiach, you have to ask myself and yourself, what is this for the glory of Christ? The scriptures say everything that you do, let it be for the glory of Christ. So are we doing this for the glory of Christ or for our own vainglory? That's what we have to ask, man. Are we doing this for the glory of Christ, man? So a lot of my old ways, man, I repented of those and don't want to do them again. Sometimes I come on here and joke, but when you know, getting serious, I'm not trying to ridicule nobody else, man, without giving them a fair one, right? Because that judgment's going to come back on me, man.
Well, now, respect to you for doing this publicly, for being humble on your own platform. Can't say that about a lot of people. But Jeremiah, if you can, bring out Titus 3:2. If it's still available. Jeremiah, you still there? Oh, yeah, you there. I see you.
Corners of the book of Titus, chapter 3 and verse 2. To speak evil of no man, to be no brawlers, but gentle, showing all meekness unto all men.
And I think
it's a lot.
Good off that. I think we, because there's just so much wickedness in this world, especially as men, we often forget how important the spirit of meekness is, right? Because it hardens and our you know, our skin, and also makes our hearts wax cold, as the scriptures say. But at the end of the day, if we're really walking in this truth, we got to protect that meekness at all times. Because if not, it's going to taint our judgment. So you can go to the book of Proverbs, chapter 15, verse 1.
Yo, Salakia, brother. Like, your ding riding is crazy, bro. Like, so you saying that because there's nobody proving that he did the things that he's not guilty, but it's people that's been, that's lied in court. Instead, a person did something they didn't do, and they still was proven guilty. So that person was guilty too. Like, it's a contradiction.
That's their court. We're not dealing with
contradiction, bro. Hold on.
We're dealing with the laws of the Most High. We're not dealing with the court system.
It's a contradiction, bro.
We're dealing with the laws of the Most High. That man's law.
If people can lie and say that the person did it and they didn't do it, and they still get, it'll be guilty in the court law.
We're not dealing with the system. We're dealing with the Most High's judgment.
Yeah, you comparing the kingdom of this world to the kingdom.
You're not listening to yourself, bro. You saying that? Oh, I'm not gonna say he did that because there's no witnesses there. So you waiting for the court system that he's gonna have to go to prove that he's wrong, right? That's what you saying right now. So what are you talking about? No, he's not going to the council of the Lord in heaven to say to condemn him. He's going to a court case in a human form and with human people. That's gonna decide if he's guilty or he's not guilty.
What are you talking about, bro?
Like, you're not making no sense, bro. I'll make an example. Jonathan Mears right now was accused, was guilty of so-called assaulting a woman, right? But the evidence showed that he didn't assault the woman, but he still was found guilty. So he's guilty.
But that's in there.
You're missing the point, brother.
You're missing the point.
Yeah, bro. Stop dick riding, bro.
You're missing the point.
We don't D-ride over here, bro. Stop D-riding, bro. Everybody's trying to stop D-riding, bro. For real.
You're missing the
crazy
point.
Y'all dividing more than TJ's right now. Being accused of, bro. You dividing more than TJ's right now, bro. Stop doing it, man. Stop dividing, bro.
You done?
It's not healthy for you, bro. Stop dividing, bro.
So, you done?
Bro, stop D-riding, bro. I'm really outside, bro. Stop D-riding, bro. I'm really outside, bro. I'm really outside, bro. Stop D-riding, bro. It's not cool. Stop D-riding, bro. Be your own man, bro. Be your own man, man. For real. Not D-riding, bro.
So let me know when you're done.
Right now, bro. It's contradicting yourself. You saying that, oh, he didn't get accused in court of being guilty, so he's not guilty. But it's people that got accused in court for being guilty that was innocent. It don't make no sense, bro. Stop D-riding. It's crazy.
You done?
Out of here, man. Pack it up, bro. Stop D-riding.
All right.
To come out that has
bro, it's ready, bro. She went to the feds, bro.
I haven't seen that. Those are allegations, man.
She went to the feds, bro. What are you talking about, bro?
I haven't seen that. You haven't seen that.
What do you mean?
I haven't seen it. You haven't seen it. You read that from a rumor.
It's the feds, bro. Because you don't know. You're not in the know, bro. You're not in the know. That's not my fault. You're not in the know. You're not in the know.
So can you present to us the evidence?
And that's why you're not going to pass any kind of judgment. You're absolutely right.
The evidence is clear, bro. The man settled in court, bro. The man settled in court the first time. Then she came out again.
That shows validity, bro.
D-Rodden, bro, got to stop.
You're mixing Puffy in with him, man.
D-Rodden got to stop, bro. Stop D-Rodden to the dot, bro. Stop D-Rodden him, bro. Because you're your own man, bro. You're a grown man, bro. Stop D-Rodden, bro. I'm really outside, bro. I'm really outside. I'm really outside, bro.
Can you present the evidence that you've seen?
Bro, I'm really outside, bro. Like, I'm not out here hiding in the house, bro. I don't hide in the house. I'm really outside, bro. Stop D-riding, bro. D-riding, bro. Stop it. I'm telling you right now, bro. Stop D-riding, bro. It's not healthy, bro, for you, bro. It's not cool.
So, you know,
if
the dude is, guilty, then the Most High judge him. Right? But I don't want to be a part of those kind of allegations anymore, man. Like, that's one of the things that people learn from One West, man. We used to always, like, you know, make people feel real bad. People walking by, passing judgment on cats, man. And it was literally turning more people away.
That's life, man. It was turning more people away than
bringing more people into the truth. You see what I'm saying? So the people wouldn't even stop and listen because you was always insulting them and putting them down. And so you're not trying to save no souls like that, man. What you're doing is trying to show how knowledgeable you are
with the Bible
and insulting people, man.
This soul been gone once this might enter his booty hole, man. Once somebody enters his booty hole, and he hit somebody's booty hole, bro. His soul was going already, bro. It's gone.
So let me ask you a question. Back, bro. Let me ask you a question then. Do you know if you're making it to the kingdom?
Bro, cut the nonsense, bro. Stop the nonsense, bro. Stop the nonsense, bro. You D-riding, bro. And I could tell, bro.
You entitled to your opinion. I don't like that, bro. It really don't matter. But you're not answering any of
you are D-riding, bro. You over here want to be a follower, bro. I'm not a follower, bro.
You're being a follower, bro.
Nah, I mean, I think, you know, it's just more of a spiritual thing, for real. I think it's more of a spiritual thing.
It's D-riding, bro.
I'm just concerned about my soul, man. That's
clear, bro. I'm concerned about my soul. If I'm hanging out with crackheads, I'm not smoking crack. So if I hang out with a crackhead, right? I'm hanging out with crackheads every day. You're not going to think I'm smoking crack, too? Come on, bro. Make it make sense, bro.
You see how he was acting on that van?
Stop, bro. You all who hang out with, bro. If you hang out with people that smoke crack, you're gonna eventually smoke crack, bro. You're gonna eventually smoke that crack too. Eventually, you're gonna get there too. I'm with crackers every day, bro. Stop it, man. y'all tripping, bro. You're not using reality, bro. Use reality, bro. Stop being in the scripture, everything, bro. The Marshall Abdomen work like that. He's in reality too. Be in reality, bro.
To prove it.
Stop, man. That D-Rod is crazy, bro. Stop D-Rodding, bro.
So prove it, bro.
I'm not D-Rodding T-Dot, bro. If he wrongs in my eyes, I'm going to say he's wrong, bro, because I'm not a D-Rodder, bro. I don't dick ride, bro. That's
fine. You entitled to that.
I don't care about no... He's a man just like me, bro. If I feel he's not making no sense, I'm going to tell him he's not making no sense, bro. And I'm going to prove out he's not making no sense, bro. I'm not going to D-Rod, bro. Be your own man, bro. Stop D-Rodding, bro.
Can you prove
it? Stop telling us I'm going to prove the scriptures, bro. See, this situation here had nothing to do with scriptures, bro. He's in a so-called pulpit. Talking about the Bible, but he in a, but after hours, he's called power bottom, bro. What are you talking about, bro? Come on, bro. Stop it, bro. Stop, bro. You D-Rod it.
Might be true, man. Now, criminal is not like civil.
Yeah, beyond reasonable doubt, huh?
But aren't they all fruity
mannerisms?
I just know it's always something going on with these pastors, you know. Individual man, but I just look at, you know, look at what happened with Eddie Long.
What happened with Eddie Long?
Come on, you know what happened with Eddie Long and them playing with them boys and all that crazy stuff he had going on.
It's been too long.
He's been playing with some boys, man.
I don't trust none of them pastors.
I thought it was just
man. We can't make. Being me in the Most High unworthy freedom, you're not supposed to make accusatory statements. Now, you men of the Most High are not without some kind of validity and evidence.
I just said the reason why I even came out because Cassie, which is Diddy's ex-girl, she went to the feds and they convinced her to expose the evidence she has. She has videotapes of him being at the sex parties that she was in because she had to reveal that she was there too. So in the tapes, she's in the tapes and so was he.
She's bad.
And they call him a power bottom. Who makes that up, man?
Who would somebody
just say that out of nowhere, man, about you, man?
A power bottom, Robin, when they when the alternative lifestyle guys,
they do it,
have intimate encounters. One of them's on the top,
and he's going, and he can take a real power bot.
Oh my God, help us!
Power thrust.
Oh my God.
Sick, man.
God, he's getting sick. Oh, God.
And, no, but it gets worse too. They said that he was making guys give him the toppings.
I swear, everybody's got a demon in them. Like, it's just that place must go straight to hell. There must be like a bunker underneath Hollywood. All of the elites are building bunkers. I wonder why. Maybe they didn't.
Jeremiah, let's have let's get some moat, man.
Let's get some moat
the 23rd chapter, man. Because if we're really men of the Most High, man, we have to reserve our judgment despite what comes out. What do you think about that, Terrence? Let's get Exodus 23, verse 1.
Khan's book of Exodus, Shemot, chapter 23 and verse 1. Thou shalt not raise a false report. Put not thine hand with the wicked to be an unrighteous witness.
So you, if you weren't there, then you're not a righteous witness, man. When someone's accused of something in the scriptures, man, it takes at least two witnesses for that person to be convicted. That's where the system got it from, man.
Corinthians.
That's where the system get it from, man. You have to bring at least two witnesses, man. Go ahead, Jeremiah.
Verse 2. Thou shalt not follow a multitude to do evil.
So the multitude might be putting dirty rumors on this man. What if it's not true? Now, we're really men of the Most High. Now, if you guys are playing, stop playing. If you're really men of the Most High, you will reserve your tongue until that true truth is brought forth. Right now, allegations are going out that could ruin this man's career. What if he didn't do it? If you're operating in the right spirit, a real wise man would say, well, you know, I hear it. It sounds, you know, you might say he act fruity. A man could have certain effeminate ways about him simply because he was raised by his mother. He wasn't raised around another man, but it doesn't mean that he's a fruitcake. You understand what I'm saying?
I'm about to send a video into the group chat right now.
Hold on. Go ahead, Jeremiah.
Neither shalt thou speak in a cause to decline after many to rest judgment.
See that? See that? A brother speaking in a cause right now, Jeremiah, I would say that they are. Go ahead.
Verse 3, neither shalt thou countenance a poor man in his cause.
See that? So we can't, if we're really righteous men of the Most High, see, we could say we are up, but when it really comes down to it, man, when your spirit is charred, are you really being righteous, man? Let's go from there. Let's go to Proverbs 26 and 20.
Cons, the book of Proverbs, chapter 26, verse 20. Where no wood is, there the fire goeth out.
Okay, if you guys don't keep spreading rumors about this man, the rumors will go away. But you guys keep putting wood on the fire without any kind of validity. I'm not saying whether it's true or not. But if you thought you put wood on that fire and that man didn't do this, you're going to get judgment for that in the end. Understand that. You keep putting wood on that fire. God.
So where there is no table bearer, the strife ceases.
See that? The quarreling ceases. This man's fighting for his reputation. Did he do it? I don't know for sure. You don't know for sure. I just know people in this world have ill intent. Huh? People have ill, malicious
intent. It's horrible. I'm just learning this, that there really are more than I thought that really just sit around and they want to hurt others. That's what they live for. That's all they do. They really are trying, and others that have been good to them. And that's sick to me, but there really are people that are like that. Yes.
I don't agree with T.G. Jakes' doctrine, but I'm not going to throw dirt on him without some sort of, because I know judgment will come to me. Go to Proverbs 11.
But let me say this, though. Cassie already came out, right, and said that Diddy was doing these things, and then Diddy, he paid her off, you know what I'm saying, so that she wouldn't bring out more stuff, right? And then she again went to the feds this time now, and then affiliated. Listen, it's a million other people in the world. Why your name popping up, and then why after your name popped up is all these videos of you really being with the God on? Like, you really was like cool with him like that, you know what I'm saying? So like, you gotta put two and two together. You just can't just say all allegations when all of a sudden now you really see that this guy,
it's not true, until I see it.
Until I see it,
what the scriptures is saying is see, worldly Negroes do that. The scriptures are saying right now, I'm reading it, Jeremiah is reading it verbatim, that righteous men don't do that. Get Proverbs 11 and 13, man. Watch this.
Call in the book of Proverbs, chapter 11 and verse 13. A talebearer revealeth secrets.
Yeah, a slanderer goes around and reveals secrets. Go ahead.
But he that is of a faithful spirit concealeth the matter.
Mm-hmm. Can I read?
Verse 14, where no counsel is, the people fall.
Yeah, where there's no guidance, people will fall. I'm just trying to bring guidance through the spirit of Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shah. Scripture say where there's no guidance, the people fall. So I suggest that we reserve our judgment, man, until the complete truth has come out. Go ahead.
But in the multitude of counselors, there is safety.
There's safety, man. When people look out, are what these people doing for the glory of the Most High? The Most High told us to have nothing to do with foolish, ignorant controversies. Is it true? I guess time will tell. But we supposed to reserve our judgment until true judgment has gone forth. This man's already being judged before trial or anything, man. Now, are we going to be men of the Most High or we're going to be worldly? Is what we really got to look at ourselves. 2 Timothy 2 and 23. Watch this, huh?
Con, this is the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2 and verse 23.
Ananias put a scary face in the room right now, man, because the Most High might be judging him. You see what I'm saying? They laugh. Yeah, I knew he was. Really? The man may seem like that, but do we know for sure? Do we really know for sure, man? What's coming from Texas, man?
Book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2 and verse 23. But foolish and unlearned questions avoid, knowing that they do gender strifes.